Hi everyone, in this tutorial video, I'm going to be showing you how you can use HOT encoding on your dataset. So what is HOT encoding? HOT encoding is a feature engineering technique that is used to achieve a much more accurate prediction on your model. So in HOT encoding, what you are basically doing is that you are converting a value to a new column. So you are converting a particular value or the values in a column or in a variable. You are creating new columns from those values. And those new columns are not going to be assigned binary values of 1 or 0. So let's say, for example, now you have a column called sex, and that column is now carrying male and female throughout the rows. So we are now going to create new columns, male, and another new column, female. The new column male is going to be carrying binary values 0 or 1. That is if the individual is a male, while the female is going to be carrying 0 if the individual is a male. So if the individual is a male, he's going to be carrying 1 at the male column. While the individual is a female, he's going to be carrying 1. She's going to be carrying 1 at the female column. So once the individual is already carrying 1 at the male column, then the other column for that of female is going to be 0. I'm going to explain it in a bit. We're going to create a sample data. So first of all, we need to load the dplyr package. We're going to be using it, and also the tidyr package. So let's create a sample data. I want to create a data of five individuals. I'm creating a data of 5 individuals. These particular individuals, I'm going to be showing their sex in a new column and also their marital status in another column. So I'm going to be using data.frame. So the first individual, names, so I'm going to give their names. The first column is going to be names. The first individual is going to be Mary, followed by Blake, followed by John, followed by David, then followed by Martha. So we have 5 individuals here. Then next, we give a column that is going to contain their sex. So Mary is a female. Mary is a female, Blake is a male, John is also a male, David is also a male, while Martha is a female. So sorry, I've been writing their names. Male, while Martha is a female. So next is now going to be their marital status. I'm going to be using 4 marital status here. I'm going to be using married. I'm going to be using single. I also have divorced. I have widowed. Married. I think this is 5. So we have 5 values under the marital status. So let's run it. Now we can view our data. Now this is our data. So in HOT encoding now, I want each of these values, married, single, to be a column on their own. So that when you go and check at the column married, then you can see that Mary will have a value of 1, meaning that she's married. But by the time you check other columns of single, divorced, widowed, and married, they are going to be carrying the values 0, meaning they are not single, divorced, widowed, or married. They are not single, divorced, or widowed. So we are now basically in HOT encoding now, want to just create 4 columns from this particular variable marital status. And also for sex too, we can create a HOT encoding too using 2 columns. That is for female and for male. So first of all, we are going to pass our data to the mutate function. And we are going to create the first new variable we are creating is the column married. So we are going to use the if else function. So if the marital status, is equals to married, if the individual is married, then it should carry a value of 1, else it should carry a value of 0. Next, we'll also do that for the divorced. So if the individual is divorced, if the marital status is equal to divorced, then the individual value should carry 1, else it should carry 0. Also for that of single, if the individual is single, so if the individual is single, then the individual value should carry a value of 1. If not single, then the individual value should carry a value of 0. If the individual is widowed, then it should carry a value of widowed. Else the individual should carry a value of 1. Else the individual should carry a value of 1. If the individual is widowed, the individual should carry a value of 1. Else the individual should carry a value of 0. So now this is our column. Can you see the one not encoding? So this particular individual, Martha, is married. Mary is also married, value of 1, while the other values remain 0. So this is a longer way of using one not encoding on your data. So there's a much, much shorter way using the pivot wider function in the tidyr package. So we're going to pass our data to mutate. So we want to create a value column, which is equals to 1. So we are creating a value column which is equals to 1. This is the value column. So all the values are going to be carrying 1. Then we are now going to use this value column in our pivot wider function. So this pivot wider function takes the names from the variable marital status and is going to take this value from the, is going to take the values from the column value. So value is going to be equals to, I'm going to say values from is equals to value, the column value. So let's have a look now and see. So now you can see that we have missing values. Now how do we take care of this? This missing values are actually indicating that there is no values for this, that means there is no values pertaining single, divorced and widowed for Mary, and since also apply to other values in Blake. So this is where we now use the argument values field. So values field is going to fill all these missing values with 0. Because the pivot wider is taking the values from that column we created value. So when you now check on it, you will see that the value for Mary was 1 and she was married. So it is going to take the name of that column, then take the value under that column. But because there is no value under single, divorced, and widowed for Mary, it is going to give missing. It is going to say that there is like a missing number. It's going to give missing values. So we're now going to replace these missing values with 0. And we have our one hot encoding applied. So this is a much more shorter way than the previous method I showed earlier on. But it is based on your choice. Anyone you feel like using, you're also going to get your one hot encoding on your data.